Hi, and welcome to today's quick tip. Do you have a lot of pictures in your email account? Well, at some point, you'll want those pictures copied from your email account to your computer. If you use Gmail, the problem is that there's no way to copy all of your pictures at once from Gmail to your computer. Sure, you can open each email in Gmail and download the picture or pictures from that one email to your computer, kind of like this. Click on the download button. Tells you the image name. We can either open it or save it. In this case, we want to save it to our local computer and then click OK. Well, imagine doing that with hundreds of emails and possibly hundreds of images. That would be a real pain in the neck to do that for many, many pictures. Well, I found a solution in a free software package called Mail Attachment Downloader by a company called GearMadge. This software allows you to download all your pictures at once from Gmail to a folder on your computer. It downloads the picture attachment only and not the email. Let me show you how it works. First, we have to create a folder on the computer to download your files to. So in this case, I'm working on Windows 7. And we just want to bring up my computer or this particular screen. We want to click on the C drive, and we'll click on New Folder, and then let's call that Pictures from Gmail. So that's where the pictures from Gmail are going to be placed on our computer, in the C drive, in the Pictures from Gmail folder. So now that we have that, let's go download Mail Attachment Downloader. They have a pro version which you can pay for, but in our case they have a free version which works great. So let's download that. So then we click on Download Now. Do you want to open or save this file? And we want to save and open. So we see Mail Attachment Downloader Install.exe. We click on or double click on that. You get this security warning. Do you want to run this file? In this case, we do. So we click on Run. So it's preparing to install. It's extracting the information. Here's the install wizard. We click on Next. We click on I accept the terms in the license agreement. If you want to install it to that folder, which you probably do, you click on Next. And then install. And it's finished, and we want to launch the program. And here it is. So we have to type in our account name on Gmail, cyberprepper@gmail.com in my case, and then we want to enter the password for that account, for your Gmail account. And if you want to reuse this every day or every month, then you might want to say save password. Then we want to find out where we selected these pictures to go to on our computer, and we selected pictures from Gmail. So, we select that folder. So now all of our files will go to there. We want to go down here and find out which folders that we want to collect. You can select all of these if you like, or in my case, I'm just going to select the inbox. But if you have a special folder for your emails or some other reason, you can check other folders here as well. Here you can see a download history if you've downloaded anything, which if it's a new installation, you won't have anything. So a couple of other configuration items we want to look at. Folder and files. We're going to do the selected folders, which is inbox. And you can tell it what kind of file names to put on your pictures as you load them into your folder on your computer. In this case, I've selected file name and date, and you'll see that in a little bit. And then create a folder on disk for every person who sent me attachments. So if you have 10 people who have sent you attachments, then you'll have 10 folders. You can either check that or not. You can put it all in one folder, or you can put it in separate folders. On the search tab, you want to get all mail and check inline content, because if emails are inside, I'm sorry, if pictures are inside of an email rather than attachments, you want to be able to get those. And so also you want to have the dates that you want to get these from. So this is the email dates. So if yours is 2001, then you want to put in 2001 here instead of 2015. In my case, end date, it's the 26th of September. I'm going to put the 27th so that anything up until midnight today will be included. And you can actually exclude things as well. That'll be something that you can look into. You can select what types of things you want to download. You could just get JPEG, and I'm not sure if TIFF is included in that or not, but you can get movie, pictures, music, documents. I've selected everything. For example, you could probably get by with just those top two, but we'll go ahead and select them. And there are other filtering options over here as well. Database, you won't do anything to. And you can also set up a schedule where it does it hourly, daily, whatever. I would do it manually at first. As you get more expert with it, you can look into some of these other options. So then we connect and download. And now it's downloading the various pictures. All right, so these are all of the pictures that it downloaded. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And if we go over to our folder on our computer that we created, we can see that it's created a new folder. And within that are our pictures. And we see the date created was today, because that's when they were pulled over. And if we change those, then we can see these are the pictures that we pulled over. And that's how you can pull all of your pictures over from Gmail to your own computer. And of course, you want to save these off to a backup device, say a USB stick, at your earliest opportunity. All right. Thanks for watching. Hope this helps.